Yes, Tim's right. The SS are deploying right around the town. Have a look.
Thanks, sir. There's an item on the BBC this morning might amuse you, sir. Yes. Quote, Member of Parliament, as the war in Europe is virtually over, will not the Prime Minister now set an immediate date for a general election?
Yes, as you say, very amusing. Well, luckily, the SS look as if they're fully occupied down there.
Yes, I can't see them sparing men to come up here on our account, sir.
No. Unless, of course, they're going to make the castle part of the defensive ring. Let's have a look,
sir.
This is entirely...
Yeah, I got absolutely right, but... you see, you've only got to try it yourself to see.
Yeah?
I mean, look, let me explain.
Uh-huh.
The advantages. One, you're on the move the whole time.
Yeah.
Never in one spot. Taking good exercise with a good chance of some fun.
Oh,
now,
good.
Where are you going to get that? I've only got to go into this, and you'll see my point straight up.
Is it my turn to move again, huh?
What? The point is, wet or dry, or whether to go up or down.
Yes, but...
Now, look, don't forget, there's so much...
Yes, but I want to teach you...
Major Carrington. Major Carrington. May I say how happy I am that the sentence was not carried out? It's a beautiful day. You may go.
Thanks.
What about a little respect for your superior officers?
Phil! Phil! Wow, is it good to see you?
It's good to see you.
They treat you all right and everything? Did you get all those messages we sent? Hey, yeah, just a minute. Hey, you guys, it's Phil. Phil's here. Hey.
Phil?
Hey.
Congratulations.
Nice to see you back.
Welcome back.
Phil, what about Dresden?
I never got to Dresden, thank God.
What?
Oh. Well, where'd they hold your court-martial?
Blackau.
Blackau?
Yeah, but afterwards, we went through Dresden. I was lucky to make it back here without being lynched.
Oh, pretty chaotic, I imagine.
All. Even in the countryside. Wires down everywhere, no communications. Thousands of people on the move. Crossroads all jammed. Slave laborers, Poles, Russians, French, Italian, Dutch. All drifting, all aiming for home.
What about the Germans, German civilians? How are they taking it?
Pushing their lives around in baby carriages, half of them. Everything is all churned up by bombs and wheels. The war isn't over. But you get the feeling that every man in Europe is on the way home.
Except for us.
Yeah, well, that's the way it was between here and Dresden.
Get a load of those Mustangs. What the hell's the matter with you? You bucking for a medal or something?
It's crazy. Because they were yours, I just felt safe.
Somebody's fouled up along the line.
You better believe it.
Well, one can't expect every American to know where Coleridge is or even what it is.
Yeah, one can't expect it, but one would kind of like it.
Did you ever finish that Stars and Stripes?
Oh, yeah. And you get the pleasure of hanging it from the roof.
No, that won't work. I can just see those SS boys in town pledging allegiance to the flag. What we've got to do is lay that thing out flat in the courtyard. Then the next time a Mustang makes a pass, it'll see it.
When you lay it out, because just in case next time it's a Messerschmitt that... Here it comes again!
Come.
Gentlemen, I have to tell you that I have received orders that all prisoners are to leave Colditz under SS escort.
Commandant, you may tell your superiors that the prisoners refuse to move.
You understand what you're saying, Colonel?
Yes.
Are you prepared to accept the consequences?
Are you?
That is mutiny.
That is self-defense. There's not a single man will march out of here under SS escort. You can tell your bosses, not a chance.
The SS are still in the town in force.
And fully occupied with their own defense. And their resources aren't limitless, Commandant. There are 1,000 men up here and we're prepared to fight.
Or are you prepared to shoot us? Let me put it another way. Are they prepared to order you to shoot us? The situation has changed a hell of a lot. They're aware of that.
Let me to General Commando. Yes. Here, General. With regard to the order for the prisoners to march southward under SS escort, they refuse to move. Yes. But, General, I cannot do... Will you take the responsibility if I use my weapons as you suggest and the prisoners are killed? Well, neither will I. The matter is closed. All the same, the SS may still move into the castle with the aim of making it a stronghold. They are more likely to do this if they think the Russians will get here before the Americans.
Oh, well, I've a hunch we'll make it first. From what I've heard in Washington, there's a good chance this whole Leipzig-Dresden area is going to be in the zone of permanent Russian occupation.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Come on, George, it's supposed to be the third window from the left.
My God, there she is.
Really?
Where is she?
Well?
Oh.
Come on, George, what's she doing?
What's she doing, George? Gefreiter Hans Baumann is really earning his cigarettes this time. Steady.
Let's see.
Chocolate.
Let's see.
Not to you, Chris.
Don't lose it. Third from the left, was it?
Yes. Yeah.
Got it. Oh. Oh, that's much eyes.
Hmm? What's he like?
Well, she's...
Yes?
She's...
She is.
Yes. Come on, let's have a go.
Steady, son. Take your turn.
Watch it, Simon.
Oh, Simon, oh, look at
you're
this.
Miles away.
He's right.
What?
American tanks.
What? Tanks. He's absolutely right. American tanks, masses of them. They're coming under fire. This damn Panzer fire's been... They're there, that's the main thing, and they're going to be many more.
It can't be more than a question of hours now.
Perhaps not. Until it actually happens.
There. I saw that.
What?
Saw the muzzle flash. And again.
Go on,
and another.
How was it in the town?
Total confusion, sir. The SS are digging anti-tank ditches. They've got ready to blast the bridge across the Mulde. The local Partei chief has got together a handful of Volkssturm. They've overturned a few carts at the far end of the bridge.
Maybe all this will become part of the Russian zone.
If we live that long.
An order came from Ober Commando. Destroy and evacuate. Secure all papers and burn them.
Sir.
And request the presence of the senior British and American officers at their earliest convenience.
I'll tell them to come at once, sir.
I said at their earliest convenience.
Yes, sir.
There it is. God almighty, more French.
My sole contribution to the Entente Cordiale.
Merci, monsieur.
Welcome to Colditz.
American. You know, there are a lot of your bombers out there. The Germans are all saying that soon you will be fighting side by side with them against the Russians.
What the
Take
hell?
Take it easy, Al.
Cigarette? Surely they don't really believe that, do they, about the Americans?
When you believe nothing, you believe everything. That's the mood they are in. That and Dallas kaput. Dallas kaput. All finished. All smashed.
Beeilen Sie sich. Sie haben noch volle vier Kisten rauszuholen. Also schneller. Wir haben keine Zeit mehr.
Poor old Gertie. What a shame.
Oh, come on, fellas. Leave him alone.
Hey, and look at this. So, Ausführung des vierten Verordnung Nummer 180.
Auch Geheimnis. Top secret.
Die nicht lesen, das ist streng geheim, nur so Trieder.
Ja, ja, streng geheim.
This stuff's years old.
Alles kaputt.
Ist nicht kaputt. Nicht kaputt.
The war is over. The war is over. But it isn't. Still many have to die.
The question which I have asked you here to discuss is not easy for me to formulate. The possibility may arise that arrangements will have to be made if the occupants of this castle pass under different control.
Do you see such an event happening in the near future, Commandant?
Well, only the most short-sighted commander could fail to take the possibility into account.
When you say the occupants of this castle, do you mean us prisoners, are you Germans, or both?
If the castle had to be surrendered to the American forces, my concern would be...
But the Russians are nearly as close.
If we should surrender to the Americans, what guarantees could you offer my staff that they would remain under American or British jurisdiction?
Guarantees?
Yes.
None whatever. But under certain conditions, certain representations could be made on your behalf by both Colonel Dodd and myself.
Whereas we would, as prisoners of war, remain in American or British hands?
Possibly, yes. The first condition will be that the defense and administration of this castle pass under our control, effective as of this moment.
That's out of the question. The Reich has not surrendered, and there is still a German garrison here in Colditz.
In that case, Commandant, both you and your garrison must take their chances.
We're not asking any favors. Just to recognize the inevitable has come to pass. It's all over for you Germans here in Colditz.
Outwardly, Commandant, nothing must appear to have changed. The sentries will do their rounds, but under my command. The armory will remain locked, but the key will be in my pocket.
And there will be no display of Allied flags? Or white flags of surrender?
Hardly, with the SS still in the town.
Very well. I will summon my staff.
May I take it that your staff and garrison will be informed of the change of state within the hour?
Yes.
Thank you, Commandant.
Thank you, sir.
All right, gentlemen, what Colonel Dodd and I intend is a complete takeover of the castle for ourselves. Yeah, yeah. But, sir, I must stress this is in complete agreement with the Commandant. The action is to prevent any move against us by the SS or any other German unit. Now, we've all learned from the radio that Hitler may well be intending a last-ditch stand in the so-called Southern Redoubt. But we don't want Kaulitz to form any part of that. So what's going to happen is we're going to form working parties to take over all the tactical positions in the castle. The most important of those, of course, is the armory. Before this meeting, I briefed Captain Downing to present an inventory of the contents. Can we have that, Nigel?
Yes, sir. In the armory itself, there are 250 rifles with 100 rounds each, 8 assorted machine guns and 2,000 rounds each, 3 boxes of stick grenades, and in addition, the duty guard has 15 rifles with 10 rounds each.
I think so. Well, there we are, gentlemen. If the worst does come to the worst, we can make quite a bang with that little. Now, what is going to happen is the German guards will retain their rifles, but their ammunition will be taken from them and locked in the armory. After that, I want 6 German guards to be on the main gate and 3 each on the other gate. George, you're going to be in command of that, all right?
Sir.
Now, my orders are that no one, and I repeat, no one, is to enter or leave the castle without my permission. We don't want anybody in the town getting wind of the change of state up here. Impress upon the German guards is as much for their good as it is for ours.
Yes, sir.
Now, Captain Downing, Flagg, and Carter, I want you to form 3 working parties from the German guards to maintain power, light, and with any luck, get the drinking water back on again. Captain Randall, I want you to issue immediately, please, to the French all the remaining blankets and a reasonable supply of the available emergency drinking water. Walters, Mawson, you're to issue immediately to all prisoners 1/2 the remaining rations. Unfortunately, that won't take you very long. But after that, I want you to hang on as quartermasters.
Sir.
Right, I want all officers to report their states to me within an hour in the Commandant's office. Gentlemen, there's one other thing. As far as I can see, we can stand by now to be shelled not only by the Americans and the Russians, but also the Germans. So the first sign of trouble, we take to the cellars. Is that understood? Yes. Right, thank you, gentlemen. Get on with it.
Simon?
This may well be the last time that I will have the chance to speak to you in orderly circumstances. I thank you for your loyalty in the past. Your duty in hard and painful times to come will require more of you than loyalty. What that duty is or will be, I cannot define for you. Nor will there be any unifying example as in the past. Each man must seek his own way. Each man must seek his own way, using his own individual resources in the changed world. Gentlemen, I am leaving this office for the last time. I suggest that we take shelter whilst this bombardment continues. I thank you.
Tanks.
Let's have a look.
No more than 2 miles away. They're moving. Tanks being fired on. Fired on from the town.
I wouldn't blame the Yanks for thinking this was a Jerry observation post.
Do you suppose this American artilleryman with his binoculars on me, watching me, watching them?
Very convoluted thinking. Personally, I'm going below.
Oh.
I wouldn't blame the Americans for blasting the entire castle off the face of the earth. To them, it's got to look like an artillery observation post.
They must be better informed than that.
Oh, must they? And what about young Jim Phipps's story about how they bombed the command post and killed the CO?
Funny. Jerry doesn't look so bad down here.
Yes. A basement full of strangers always seems to me far more vulnerable than an upstairs drawing room with a few chaps.
One of our men was killed by a shell in the Kommandantur, and three others were wounded.
I'm sorry. Are you, sir?
What?
Are you sorry?
Yes, in a funny way, I suppose I am. Yesterday would have been different, but today... The whole thing is so nearly over, it doesn't make a lot of sense, does it?
What are they singing?
It's a French army song from the early 19th century, Grâce à nos canonniers. Thank you for our artillerymen. Of course, then we were fighting them.
And us. When it's all over, John, what do you think's going to happen to Europe? I know what we ought to do. Go right through to Berlin. Finish it.
What the hell was that?
The bridge! They must have blasted the bridge on the Mulder.
Is that good or bad?
Good for whom? Bad for whom? I don't know.
What the hell side is he on anyhow?
A winning, of course.
If you ask me, they'll blow this place to bits in the morning.
Yeah, who will?
Well, the Americans, obviously. Who else? Nobody's briefed them. Plaster this place with high explosives and blow it to smithereens. What have they got to lose? Not one of their own men, certainly.
What do I look like? Chopped liver?
It looks pretty quiet at the moment, Max. They've found some wine in one of the other cellars. I think they might as well have some dinner.
How many bottles?
Enough to go round.
C'est fertig.
Also Hans, was machst du?
Gehe spazieren.
Sag mir Hans, wer ist mit dir?
Kriegsgefangener, Amerikaner. Hm? Was gibt's im Stadt?
Im Stadt? Alles nicht in Ordnung dort.
Wo ist die Frontlinie?
Frontlinie? Frontlinie? Gibt es nicht mehr.
Und die SS?
Alles weg. Steht nur eine Kompanie der 148er. Und ein paar Jungs bei der Brücke.
Alles weg. Unmöglich.
Sag mir, Hans, wer von euch beiden ist der Gefangene?
understand, there is no more front line. The SS are all gone. There is no more order in the town.
Yes.
And in contrast to the society we see all around us, we had to evolve our own system of governing ourselves. Simple, primitive, natural, village, POW, democracy. You know who I want to thank for that? The Germans. Thank ye, for ye knew not what ye did.
Half a kilometer in this direction stands a bridge. Yesterday it was heavily guarded. Tonight, I don't know. It's best you try here.
It wouldn't.
No.
It wouldn't.
No. No, you see, on the other hand, Phil said that if there was a continuous line, he wouldn't go through it.
You know, the whole town's crawling with SS.
So, if it is, you'll come back and tell us.
Well, if he does make it, if he gets through to the army, hope he has the sense to remain where he is.
It's in public domain.
Who are you?
United States prisoner of war.
Identify yourself.
Carrington Philip. Major, U.S. Army. Serial number 02469731.
Just stay right where you are.
Can you hurry up? I'm freezing.
So bloody quiet, I can't sleep.
Nice going, Major.
What rank are you, soldier?
PFC.
Is an officer around here?
He's Captain Andrews, a couple of hundred yards down the road.
How about running me down to see him?
Just walk right in front of me, Major.
First time in 4 years, I don't know what's going to happen. What are you going to do?
I got the scheme, sell an army surplus after the war. Because there'd be all these depots,
I don't know. And the army's the only thing I've ever been trained for. How about you, George?
I'm going to start from scratch. Train as a zoologist.
You mean there's money in bugs?
It's entomology.
There's Phil. You didn't manage it.
Yes, I got through.
And?
Well, the SS have left the town. It's being defended by Folkestone.
Folkestone? What the hell's Folkestone?
Civil defense. Our artillery's got the word. They were ordered to level anything that shows resistance. They want us to put out a flag.
Why didn't you stay over on the other side? Could have met you at the Starlight Roof.
I told you, they want us to put out a flag. Come on, let's get it.
National flags are being displayed. Also white flags. They have broken their agreement.
There's a column of tanks on the far road. Tanks and half tracks heading east. I haven't actually seen an American tank enter the town.
Of course, they could be bypassing us.
What are you talking about?
Well, if they think this place is going to be heavily defended, they may decide to flow on by. I mean, pockets of resistance are often left to stew in their own juice.
Not if they're strategic.
For heaven's sake, Chris. We left the Germans in charge of La Havre all last autumn and winter. Don't tell me La Havre isn't a hell of a sight more strategic than this place.
You always look on the bright side, don't you, Downing?
Well, I'm just trying to guard against being let down. That's all. Oh, voilà. La paix, c'est à moi. Alors,
tu fais la paix, hein? Oui. Attention, la paix. Les pieds, là. Les pieds.
Ah, c'est
important. Voilà la barre.
Oh, c'est merveilleux!
Oui,
oh.
C'est ça. Et voilà.
Ah oui! Oh.
C'est le verre qui gagne! C'est le verre qui gagne! Voilà!
C'est la seule journée qui vient. Non. On va voir les autres. Hein?
Oui.
Thank you.
actually believe it?
Not until I walk through those gates, I don't.
Just through the gates now.
All right. But what are we waiting for? Come on, let's just pack up and leave.
All right. I'm not packing anything. I'm going to walk through there with my hands in my pockets.
Hold on, where's Colonel Preston?
We were kind of getting driven up here, sir, by our own fire. Well, this looked like the safest place in town. There's no guard on the lower gate, so we forced it open.
Atta boy.
Mine's done.
Boy, what a day. It was touch and go, I'll tell you. They were nearly shelled this place with incendiaries.
Colonel. Major Carrington.
Major.
How are Captain you? Captain Nugent, Colonel Harris.
Captain, Colonel? I was just telling the colonel here. We almost set this place afire.
Yeah, we could feel the heat. How's it going down there?
Well, there was some resistance. It's not over yet down there. Well, gentlemen, what do you need? Food, cigarettes?
You just gave us what we need.
Well, as soon as we get some trucks organized, we'll get you guys shipped out of here, all right?
It's finally happened.
Yes, it does.
I suppose you'll be all packed. Pretty much so.
Well, what are we going to do now, sir? Just walk out of the place?
Oh, I think you can do better than that, unless, of course, you're keen on walking. I'll see if I can get some transport out of those chaps.
Except for the Major here, who paid a previous visit. We've been here 6-7 months. In the case of the British, some of them as much as 5 years. Colonel Preston, Colonel Harrity.
My pleasure, sir.
How do you do?
Well, if there's anything you fellas need, within reason, just say the word and I'll try to make it available.
Well, when it becomes available, I think we'd all like transport.
Yes, sir. That'll be the first order of business. Now, what about these guys? What do you want me to do with them? Do they treat you all right, or is there anything I should take care of right away?
In what terms?
Justice. Quick, clean, simple. No red tape.
No, Colonel. What they did was normally nothing more than their duty. I request that they be confined and remain in American custody.
Well, they would anyhow, but any special reason?
Within the limitations of their duty, they cooperated these last days. Saved many lives.
Well, that's all I wanted to know. Well, I imagine they're waiting for some formal kind of procedure. Do you want me to take it, Colonel, or do you want to handle it?
John?
I think they should surrender to the American First Army.
Right. You're the senior officer here?
Commandant, prisoner of war, Special Camp 4C. 1,500 officers and men, unhurt. Nominal role herewith.
Colonel Harrity, 9th Armored Division. I'm ready to accept your surrender.
I surrender on behalf of my officers and myself on the understanding that we will, as prisoners of war, be treated according to the terms of the Geneva Convention.
Yes, sir. Lieutenant!
Excuse me. Excuse me, gentlemen.
Sir, take charge of these people, will you? Oh, and I don't want them in any POW cage. Just keep them with us under guard until we can ship them back to Corps, right?
Sir. Sergeant!
Okay, Lieutenant!
Let's move them out!
Well, Commandant, in 4 years, this is the first time we've said goodbye. A lot has happened to us.
This reversal of our positions will seem the least important. Anyway, to me. In those years, we have both lost something which is more precious than freedom. Your wife, my son. You have shown me the way that one can survive both imprisonment and loss.
Thank you.
You have won a great victory here. You yourself.
One never thinks of it like that. There's no victory in imprisonment.
I am quite sure you would not think of it that way, Colonel Preston.
Goodbye, Commandant.
Goodbye. Colonel?
All right. Get those prisoners loaded up and form a pecking convoy.
I'll see what I can line up in the way of transport, but do me a favor, will you, Colonel? They'll go leaving here in groups of twos and threes. There's still a lot of crazy guys around in this part of the world, so keep together, huh? Be seeing you.
Let's go, Lieutenant. Good luck, you boys.
Come on, Simon. That's one thing you're not going to be needing anymore.
Where did you liberate that from?
The waterworks.
Taking it back to England.
Okay, fellas, hold it down. Well, Colonel, we got 20 trucks lined up outside, ready to take you to an airfield near Chemnitz. How long would it take your men to get ready to leave?
About a minute and a half.
We're off!
Wait!
Funny, I don't feel like saying cheerio to this place.
In fact, we'll probably never say goodbye to it completely.
Yeah, I bet we have nightmares.
Soon be seeing your wife.
Yes, sir.
I will see you at the airfield, Colonel.
And on the plane to England.
Yeah,
sir.
Thanks a lot,
England. See you later.
Please board the transport.